As you saw on the thumbnail, today we are going to work on a flop, so grab some popcorn and let's begin. Hello friends, welcome back. So, as I promised you on last Wednesday, today we are going back to the P47 and work on the flaps, since I need this model to have the flaps on the down position. And since I didn't bought any aftermarket for this, I thought I could make it work with the flaps that came molded on the wings. So I've cut the flap section before gluing the two halves, since it was easier to do this. And when I had the first cut done with the scalpel, I switched to my razor saw to make the cut all the way, since I didn't want to spend the whole day cutting the flaps, so a razor saw is way faster. And finalizing again with the scalpel on the corners, because the razor saw doesn't reach all the way. Then I switched to the top part, again repeating the same process, making the first pass with the scalpel, and then switch to the razor saw again. This method allows you to preserve the parts and reuse them, in this case is what I will do. And to release this corner, just... well... with the two parts separated from the wing, I glue them together, so there will be only one part, or one flap. I'm using extra thin cement from Ammo-Mig. Dries very fast and leaves no marks. Now it's time to check if the cuts we done are not exaggerated, but I can see on the down position it's a big gap and I don't like it. And my quick solution was to do this. Of course I tested before to be sure it worked, and as you can see it's pretty good, I say. Now you may want to know how I did this. So I got some styrene rods, I guess it's a 2mm one. I sanded one side. Well, a rod doesn't have sides, but you get the idea. You have to flatten one spot and don't sand your fingers. And you need to sand until you have something like a semicircle shape. It doesn't need to be perfect, because after all what we want is to fill this gap, and we have to use putty in the end, so the closer you get with the shape, the less putty you have to use. Next, I again with my trusty extra thin cement from Ammo, I glued the half rods. The styrene part. So I glued it on the flap and allowed it to dry around 1 hour. Then I cut the excess with my nippers to protect the surface and the rivets that already came molded on the flap. I used a bit of masking tape to prevent the putty to go where I didn't want. I will use the Tamiya putty, the basic type, to fill this small gap between the styrene rod and the plastic part, because I sanded the rod a bit too much. Now, like my friend says, putty always resolve. Next, we have to do a small modification on the wing, because the flap won't fit. I will use my mini Dremel for this purpose, with a milling bit, I guess. Remove like 80% of the excess material. And I will switch to my scalpel to remove these small plastic bits that the milling bit created, followed by some sanding with the new Amomig sanding sticks that I recommend you to try them because they are really good. And like 1 hour after I let the putty completely dry, I start sanding the excess with a 180 sanding sponge, I guess. You may think that it's a bit too much aggressive, but it will make a quick work out of the excess. So I could go directly to the 4-step sanding stick from Ammo. Besides the sanding stick you are seeing right now, there are two more different types, but my favorite is this one, the standard sanding stick with 4 different grits, 180, 3020, 600, and I think the last one is 2000. And after like 15 minutes of sanding, I tested the fitting of the part, and as you can see, that horrible gap is finally gone. And since we got our hands dirty, I will take the opportunity to modify the elevators, because I need them on the down position too. Not as much as the flaps, but just a bit. I will start by cutting with the scalpel, and this time I won't cut all the way like I did on the flaps. It's like half a millimeter down on both sides, just enough to not break the elevator from the plastic part. I know it's probably not the best way to do this, but well, this is how Modest Modeler does, so please don't kill me. I'm sure you'll like the final result. So after some back and forth with scalpel, I finally got the elevator to bend without breaking. I position it on the, well, position I wanted, and glued it in place with some extra thin cement from Ammo. And I applied the glue on both sides to be sure it will stay in place. And this is the final result of the elevators. Now it's time to glue the flaps in place. And you probably are wondering why the plane is now riveted, and on the beginning of the video it wasn't. So I modified the flaps before riveting the whole plane, and then I left them aside to make my job easier. And since the next step is to paint this little bird, I'm gluing the last pieces in place. And I think it's everything for this week, my friends. So if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave a like, comment and subscribe to the channel, and most importantly, to share this video with your friends. And if you want to see more progress, follow me on Facebook or Instagram. And I'll see you next week, when we are finally going to paint this bad boy. So, bye bye!